with a demo. I want to show you what you can do with point clouds, because point clouds look here quite boring, right? What do you want to do with points? So recently it becomes more and more popular to have point clouds. So you can have like professional work, like huge point clouds that you record with cars like this. And maybe in the future, in 3 or 4 or 5 years, you have a Google car and it also has a laser scanner built in. So maybe you get an API to get the point clouds. But at the moment, this is too expensive for me. So I thought how to make my own point cloud. I didn't want to download one. And the ingredients you need is you need a drone with a camera, and thanks to Osaka City University, they just bought one this summer. And you need post-processing software I will explain later. And then there's some JavaScript libraries that can actually bring your data in the browser so that you can show it to others. And then you need a browser that can do WebGL. And that's pretty much every browser in the meanwhile. I don't know Internet Explorer, but yeah, maybe newer versions do it too. So you only need such a toy and with a camera, and then you have a good reason, actually. What is this? This browser cannot play a video. No? Yeah. Should have been Chrome. Is here Chrome? Oh. Doesn't matter. No, so I will post the link, and then you can also watch the video. So you can fly with these toys, and when you are, and then flying is fun. But then you want to collect data, and you send them on a flight path, and you just hope that they come back, and they fortunately come back, and they come back with a lot of data. You suddenly have a folder full of images, and I have learned that the images are very distorted, so you have to try to make them more flat, and that works with open source software. And then you better do that on the weekend when you don't want to work, because your computer is busy for a while. So it really takes a time. So you have some software that you can test for 1 month. And after that, you have to pay for it. It's called PhotoScan. And with PhotoScan, you can make cool things for 1 month, and then you have to pay. So I'm still searching for a way how to do this with open source software, if Grass can do it or some other software. But it seems to be not so trivial, and you have to spend some time to do. But with this software, you can get a result very quickly. You cannot work at the same computer then, because it takes all your CPU and memory. Yeah, and you wait a little bit and have a coffee, or you go to bed, because you can't touch your computer anymore. It really. So and then after a day, you have a file. I think I took about 100 photos, and the photos were all glued together and tried to could detect edges and was rectified. And then you have I had a 1.2 gigabyte LAS file. There's 45 million points. And then who heard about open layers? How many points can you put on an open layers map? There was something like 1,000, and then Internet Explorer is gonna be dead. But with WebGL you can do that, but still you don't need to you don't have to show all points, because you won't be able to see all points. So this pod tree has a converter. And this converter implements an octree data structure, and it just means that what you have now with a tile layer, you have also multiple layers, but they are just also with the height dimension. So you have many small blocks, and as you zoom in, as more details it shows. And it's organized in nodes, and each node contains a sparse subset of points. And when you run this converter, you can specify spacing and levels. So you have to find out and try what's the best performance versus quality. So if you have a very big point cloud, you maybe make more spacing and drop more points. And then when we started with this, when I selected to use this PodTree converter, it was just a download link. So it was a project by Markus Schütz from Austria. And he started a little bit like PG Wooting started with a download link, but then you don't grow a community and nobody's going to help you. So I said, look, let's try to make this, put this on GitHub. It didn't take 3 weeks and the first person from 3JS, actually, some developer from there came, and so Markus also decided to switch his self-written WebGL implementation to 3JS. So now it's based on some solid framework. And it can do point cloud rendering in the web browser. It was a bachelor thesis, but in the meanwhile, it's a master thesis. And not only we are able to fund Markus a little bit, but he also got from Martin Eisenberg and some other people, he gets funding to implement more geo features. It's a pure JavaScript and WebGL solution, so it doesn't need any plugins. It renders only visible regions, so you don't see anything that is behind you. It doesn't bring that load that. And it renders up to a certain level of detail, and more details are loaded over time. So you can do everything else that 3JS can do. You can set as a background a movie or a street view image or whatever you want to do. And now the demo doesn't work because it's only offline. Maybe I put that all together somewhere on a web server and then you can try it out. But you can also just search for PodTree and there will be also demos you can check. Yeah, one slide is missing that I created. So there's another software project that is called Plasio. I can actually show it here. So it's called Plasio, and it's by the famous Howard Butler. And it's also very interesting because you can just show your local point cloud there in the browser. If you have one, if the internet is fast, you can also open an existing one. And some of these, this source code was integrated already in PodTree, and also Howard Butler actually interested in taking something to his project. For example, here it can decompress zipped LAS files in the browser. It has a JavaScript decompressor, and that one is also already part in PodTree now. So there's a lot of improvement almost every week, something new. And yeah, so if you have a point cloud, then this is a very, if you're interested in this topic, then this is very, very interesting to try it out, I think. Or if you're sitting too much on your computer, just buy such a drone, and then you have a good reason to go to the park and play a little bit, and then you can say it's for working. I don't know exactly when I started, so yeah. If you have I will ask you for questions. If you don't have any question now, you can also ask me later. I think point cloud is a big topic will be a big topic in the next years. So I've heard a lot of presentations recently about it.
はい、時間結構早く喋ってくれたので、挽回できたと思いますけど。
日本語でも聞いてもいいです。